Hey guys, this is a non-pressurized coolant reservoir tank. Have a look at this. Because this cap is cracked, this is causing the coolant from this tank to evaporate rapidly. This must be replaced. This Honda is, however, only driven around 17,000 kilometers, so why did it crack? You see this yellow mark over here? This was done by the driver of the vehicle. They marked this as the full line and would top up the coolant to this level. The max line is way down over here. This extra space you have here is meant to be empty. Coolant expands when hot. By filling it up to here, there isn't enough room for expansion. This plastic cap, this whole area is not airtight. It is meant to be the weakest part of the system where excess coolant could escape from. There are also holes on the side over here to allow extra pressure and coolant to exit. Better this area damaging due to extra pressure than some other part of the cooling system. So as I said before, this is meant to be, this is by design. The result of this extra pressure would have compromised the integrity of this cap, and plus this was tightened way too much, thus it cracked. I can see damage over here due to over tightening. It is normal for coolant to evaporate from these type of reserve tanks. You do have other types of pressurized tanks where the radiator cap is on these plastic tanks itself instead of the radiator. That's a different design. Going to remove this tank to clean it out in case there's any dirt inside. This is held by a single 10 millimeter bolt. Just pull it up and out. This cap is fairly easy to replace. You have to remove this bottom hose. And just be careful because this joint over here also could be compromised due to the extra pressure. I have snapped this in the past also on my own vehicle. Now we just push this cap down. So here you can see the crack. I will, however, be replacing this joint too, just in case this is compromised. This cost around $2. And the cap itself was less than a dollar, so might as well replace it. Cleaned out the tank, and you can clearly see the max and the minimum level written, so don't cross this level. If you see that your coolant is, you know, at the minimum level within a week or two, then there's a problem. So in this case, because the cap was cracked, that allowed the coolant to evaporate at a very rapid rate, and that would drop to the minimum level quite quickly. So always check this cap first, and then if that's not an issue, you have to check your cooling system. To put this bottle back, this tab over here has to go down into that slot over there. And just put the 10 millimeter bolt back in. Don't over tighten this. Again, this is a plastic cap. The torque spec for this, I believe, is around 7.2 pound foot. When topping up the coolant, always use the same type of coolant you have in the system. Never mix different types of coolant that could damage your system. This is still on the factory filled Honda Type 2 coolant, and it comes as a premix. As far as I know, you cannot get this in a concentrate. And that's at the max level. The total capacity of this tank up to the max level is around 400 milliliters, I believe. Just put this back and do not over tighten this cap. It will not stop the coolant from evaporating. Just snug it tight. That concludes the video, and you've seen the consequence of overfilling coolant. So this was really the best consequence, having only a cracked cap whose cost was less than a dollar. As always, thanks for watching.